Kohberger, silent in court, forcing the judge to enter a guilty plea on his behalf. Serial killers often have a pathological aversion to dependency. They do not want to depend on anyone around them. So what they do is they project their dependency needs into others and make others feel dependent upon them. So, good example, he DMs one of the girls, one of the victims. She does not get back. Dependency needs crushed. He sneaks into her house in the dead of night, bludgeons her, slashes her. Now she is dependent upon him for her life. If you look around you and you look in society, you will see these kinds of reversals all over the place. Serial killers feel at some pathological, dysfunctional, toxic level that they are bad and worthless. Think about Kohberger's history. I mean, he was underweight, he wasn't liked by girls. So what do? They react against that sense of shame and unimportance by turning it into its opposite. This is what we call a manic defense. When they turn it into its opposite, they become omnipotent, grandiose. This is what Kohberger did when he was a proctor or an assistant in college. So let's go back to his silence in court, his refusal to enter his own plea. Could it be that this is a form of arrogance? Is this what Kohberger's doing with the judge, with the defense, with the prosecutors, getting them to try to extract something from him because in his mind they need him, they want him, rather than him cooperating and just freely giving them what they need? This is what we might see more of when this case goes to trial.